Then after this, after that, there is no cut, there is no more test, there is no more trials, there is no more difficulties. So be happy that this is the last, this is the ending. So the only ending is death. So therefore, at every time and in every condition, we must remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also commands us in the Quran, وَدُعُوهُ خَوْفًا وَطَمَعًا. Always remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, supplicate to Him with خَوْفًا وَطَمَعًا, fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and in love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and hoping from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Prophet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran in other places, many places. He says, the Prophet ﷺ, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا فِي قَرْيَةٍ مِّن نَبِيٍّ إِلَّا أَخَذْنَا أَهْلَهَا بِالْبَأْسَاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَضَرَّعُونَ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَضَرَّعُونَ. In other place, that I have not sent prophets to nations before you, but then those nations were tested with difficulties and hardship. Those people were tested, those prophets were tested with difficulties and hardships. Why? Not because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not like them, and not because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to destroy them, but لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَضَرَّعُونَ, so that they turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They see the sign of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so they remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they turn back to Him, and they make repentance. And another place Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا إِلَىٰ أُمَمٍ مِّن قَبْلِكَ فَأَخَذْنَاهُمْ بِالْبَأْسَاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ. Another place Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is speaking about the Bani Israel. He says, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, وَمَا نُرِيهِمْ مِنْ آيَةٍ إِلَّا هِيَ أَكْبَرُ مِنْ أُخْرَى. That I used to send, and I sent upon them one ayah after another ayah, one miracle after another miracle, or one some kind of punishment, then after another kind of punishment, and severe punishment. Why? وَأَخَذْنَاهُمْ بِالْعَذَابِ. And I took them with punishment, a greater punishment. Why? لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted them to turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and seek His pleasure and forgiveness. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in another place, explaining what He did with them, فَأَرْسَلْنَا عَلَيْهِمُ الطُّوفَانَ وَالْجَرَادَ وَالْقُمَّلَ وَالطَّفَادِعَ وَالدَّمَ آيَاتٍ مُفَصَّلَاتٍ. Continuously, one after another, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would send them ayah and His miracles, so that they know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they see the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah said, وَبَلَوْنَاهُمْ بِالْحَسَنَاتِ وَالسَّيِّئَاتِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ. Sometimes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests people with difficulties, and sometimes بِالْحَسَنَاتِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives them too much, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests them with His favors. Why? لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ, so that they turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And sometimes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests people because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to elevate their status, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to forgive their sins. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows that if this person is not being tested and everything is easy for him, he will be, he will transgress and he will commit sins. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَوْ رَحِمْنَاهُمْ وَكَشَفْنَا مَا بِهِمْ. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had forgiven them, وَكَشَفْنَا مَا بِهِمْ مِنْ ضُرِّهِ, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala removed his difficulties from them, لَلَجُّوا فِي طُغْيَانِهِمْ يَعْمَهُونَ, they will turn away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and start going in the wrong direction. وَلَقَدْ أَخَذْنَاهُمْ بِالْعَذَابِ فَمَا اسْتَكَانُوا لِرَبِّهِمْ وَمَا يَتَضَرَّعُونَ. In the end, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says He wants that we make tadarru' to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In many places Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ثُمَّ لَا أَوَلَا يَرَوْنَ أَنَّهُمْ يُفْتَنُونَ فِي كُلِّ عَامٍ مَرَّةً أَوْ مَرَّتَيْنَ. That He tests people with difficulties and hardship once or twice or many times. ثُمَّ لَا يَتُوبُونَ وَلَا هُمْ يَذَّكَّرُونَ. So that they turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and remember Him, and seek Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's guidance and His protection. وَلَنُذِيقَنَّهُمْ مِنَ الْعَذَابِ الْأَدْنَى دُونَ الْعَذَابِ الْأَكْبَرِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in many other places, He mentions the stories of Munafiqeen and the Kuffar and previous nation, where they turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only in bad times, in difficult times. And whenever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala removed their difficulty, they turn away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and went back to their old lifestyle. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not want this from us. Allah wants us to be connected with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at all times. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, مَا أَصَابَ مِنْ مُصِيبَةٍ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ وَمَنْ يُؤْمِنْ بِاللَّهِ يَهْدِ قَلْبَهُ. that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nothing comes to you. No difficulty or goodness come to you. But with the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَمَنْ يُؤْمِنْ بِاللَّهِ يَهْدِ قَلْبَهُ. But when this happens to you, and you are connected with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يَهْدِ قَلْبَهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enlightens your heart. So what happens is, you turn back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you see it as a sign. You see it as a reminder. Instead of crying and instead of doing other things, you see it as a sign. And you immediately turn back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and seek His forgiveness. And appreciate his signs. And remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, yahdi qalba. That's what Imam al-Tabari and many Mufassirin said, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enlightens him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala let him know that this is a sign from, and he remembers it, and he sees it as a sign from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us all tawfiq. And this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, in this hadith, I will conclude with this, he said, in Allah, idha habba abdan, sometime the sign of Allah subhanahu that Allah the sign that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves you is that in Allah idha habba abdan, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves people, ibtalahu, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put them through difficulties and hardship and tests and adversities, liyasma' tadarru'ahu, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to listen to their repentance and their crying and their connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They're begging to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for ease and comfort. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala likes to listen to it, likes to listen to their dua. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among these kind of people. Wa sallallahu ta'ala ala khayri khalqihi Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Rahmatika ya rahmat.
أشرف الخلق أجمعين خاتم الأنبياء وإمام المرسلين سيدنا مولانا محمد وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين والصحابة والتابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، يا أيها الناس اعبدوا ربكم الذي خلقكم والذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. اللهم لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. اللهم انفعنا بما علمتنا وعلمنا ما ينفعنا وزدنا علما. اللهم علمنا الكتاب والحكمة وفقهنا في الدين وجعلنا هداة مهتدين وإماما للمتقين غير ضالين ولا مضلين. إنك يا ربنا سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات. الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي أمر بالصدق والإخلاص ونهى عن الشرك والنفاق وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ولا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين وأصلي وأسلم على حبيبنا وقدوتنا وسيدنا محمد البشير والنذير الصادق الأمين وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد فاتقوا الله عباد الله حق التقوى ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون واعتصموا بحبل الله جميعا ولا تفرقوا واذكروا نعمة الله عليكم وتمسكوا بكتاب ربكم وسنة نبيكم فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وعليكم بالجماعة فإن يد الله مع الجماعة ومن شد شد في النار واعلموا أن الله أمركم بأمر عظيم بدأ فيه بنفسه وثنى بملائكته فقال عز وجل قائلا عليما إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا مولانا محمد وعلى آله وذريته وارض اللهم عن الخلفاء الراشدين أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن الصحابة أجمعين وعن الأئمة المهتدين وعنا معهم بعفوك وكرمك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم اجعل جمعنا هذا جمعا مرحوما وجعلنا تفرقنا من بعده تفرقا معصوما ولا تدع معنا شقيا ولا محروما اللهم فرج هم المهمومين ونفس كرب المكروبين وفك أسر المأسورين واقض الدين عن المدينين واشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين اللهم انصر الإسلام وأعز المسلمين وأعل كلمة الحق والدين ومكن عبادك الموحدين واغفر لنا ولجميع المسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك يا ربنا سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروا الله العلي العظيم الجليل يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم واستغفروه يغفر لكم واتقوه يجعل لكم من أمركم مخرجا وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر
Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim Malik Yawm Al-Din Iyaka Na'budu Wa Iyaka Nasta'in Ihdina الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد الله سمع الله لمن حمده الله